We've been absolutely crushing it here on the channel, and I cannot thank you guys enough for your support. There's so much more work to be done. Beyond Light just came out. We have Season of the Hunt coming up. I'm so excited for everything. I can't wait to get some more videos out to you guys. But enough of that, let's get into today's video. What's going on, guys? Welcome back to the channel. So Beyond Light is finally here, and with that, we have a brand new seasonal artifact, the Fang of Zebu of Wrath. In today's video, I just wanted to run through all the mods that we have and give you guys a couple of my recommendations for mods you definitely should pick up. If you're not familiar with what a seasonal artifact is and how to level it up, I'm going to link you guys to my original video where I go in depth about the seasonal artifact, how to level it up, and what its purpose is. So to quickly jump into this, as usual in the first column we have all of our champion mods. Now as you can see, all of these are slotted into your armor pieces, so what that means is you'll be able to use all of your favorite exotics and gain the benefit of the champion mods. This adds a lot more viability to those exotics that many of us have been craving to use. If you have a particular exotic that you're a fan of, definitely comment down below and let me know which one you're going to use to run in things like the Raid and the Master Nightfalls. Now this season, all of these mods are going to be slotted into your gauntlets. So to start things off, we have the overload rounds on the auto rifle, unstoppable rounds on the hand cannon, anti-barrier for the pulse, overload rounds for the scout rifle, and anti-barrier for the submachine gun. Now again, you take your choice in which one you want to use. You don't have to use all of them. Here you can see I've unlocked 4 out of the 5. Now in the next two columns, there is a slight change that Bungie's made here. As you may notice, there aren't any enhanced mods, and that's because, as I mentioned in my previous video about all the mod changes made in Armor 2.0 for Beyond Light, Bungie's removed all of the enhanced mods in the game and buffed all the normal mods to basically work just like the enhanced mods. So as you can see here, we have a bunch of mods here that benefit the hand cannon, pulse rifle, scout rifle, shotgun, and grenade launcher. Now in this next column, usually we would see currency mods, but this season Bungie's made changes to the ghost, which I'm going to make a video about and go a little bit more in depth to explain how exactly that works. But all you need to know is if you're looking for ways to increase your currency gains, you're going to definitely want to take a look at your ghost this season. Now in this third column, Bungie's replaced those currency mods with more weapon mods. So I definitely recommend, depending on your playstyle, take a look at these two columns here and choose wisely which mods you want to make use of. Now the moment everybody's been waiting for are these final two columns, and at the time of recording this video, I haven't unlocked them myself, but I've eyeballed a couple of these in these final two columns that I definitely want to unlock. So to start things off, we're going to take a look at Momentum Siphon, which recharges your melee ability whenever you or a member of your fireteam staggers a champion. Next up, we have Surge Eater, where you recharge your grenade ability whenever you or a member of your fireteam disrupts a champion. We also have Unstoppable Schwarzschild Condenser, so void melee abilities will stagger unstoppable champions, and also stagger unshielded combatants. Thermal Overload, so your solar and stasis grenades are going to cause disruption, delaying any ability regeneration and lowering the combatant's damage output. And as always, this is strong against all the overload champions. Spoils of War is actually an improved version of the heavy finisher mod that Bungie previously had on the seasonal artifact. This time around, whenever you defeat a champion by using a finisher, you'll spawn heavy ammo for both you and your fire team. Next up, we have Unstoppable Shotgun, which, as the name suggests, your shotguns will now be able to stagger unstoppable champions and also stagger unshielded combatants. Pyretic Embrace, whenever you cast your super, you'll be restoring yourself back to full health and shields. And if you're a hunter with a golden gun, trust me when I say, this is very much appreciated. As it currently stands in the game, I think Hunter's Golden Gun is the only super that does not gain increased damage resistance when it's popped, so this is definitely appreciated. Next up is Berserker. When your super ends, you're going to gain a temporary bonus to your weapon damage, and the duration and strength of this bonus is increased based on the number of combatants you've defeated during your super. So if you're running a roaming super, or especially with stasis, if you can stack up a lot of kills, Berserker is going to come in handy. Next up is Abyssal Charge. For anybody who runs Charge with Light, and if you're not familiar, I have a video on the channel, be sure to check that out. Basically, you'll become Charge with Light anytime you defeat any combatants with void melee abilities. And last but not least, we have Thermal Blooming, where rapidly defeating combatants with solar or stasis melee attacks will create an orb of power for your fire team members. Now, I wanna quickly go over the final two columns and give you my recommended mods that I would unlock. Now, the way this works, in the second to last column, we'll be able to unlock 3 mods, and in the final column we'll be able to unlock 2. I'm going to be picking 3 mods here, starting off with Spoils of War. I definitely think this is going to be a good mod for anybody to pick up, especially if you're running end game activities, as you'll be able to not only help yourself spawn heavy ammo, but spawn heavy ammo for your teammates, which can come in very clutch for those really challenging activities like raids and master nightfalls. Thermal Overload is the next one I'm going to be picking up. Since I don't really put too much priority on running overload for my weapons, with the way that you can work your ability cooldowns, having the ability to disrupt overload champions with your grenade definitely will come in clutch. And the final mod I'll definitely say to pick up from here is going to be Unstoppable Schwarzschild Condenser, where your void melee abilities can stagger unstoppable champions. Now, you don't have to go exactly by what I'm suggesting here, but the way I play, the ability to stagger champions is extremely vital. And as you move along in the game, being able to move those abilities over from your weapons to your actual character's abilities, to me, is extremely valuable. Now, for the final column, we have two mods that we're going to pick. First up, I'm definitely going to be picking up Pyretic Embrace. Personally, I run Golden Gun a lot, so having the ability to get full health and shields whenever I cast my super is extremely valuable to me, not just in PvE, but especially in PvP, where again, any hunter knows Golden Gun has zero damage resistance, so the ability to actually heal yourself by casting your super, it's not something I could pass up. The last mod I'm going to be picking up in this final column is definitely going to be Berserker. If you haven't tried Stasis yet, trust me when I say you can definitely wipe out a whole lot of adds and should be able to gain a nice bonus to your weapon damage from this mod. So this is definitely going to be one that I pick up. Now, if I had to switch up one of them, I would definitely say that in the second to last column, I'd probably not pick up Unstoppable Schwarzschild, maybe pick up either Surge Eater or Momentum Siphon, and then in the last column pick up Unstoppable Shotgun, because in my opinion, one of the best weapons that we've gotten so far in Beyond Light is gonna have to be the Duality Shotgun. Now, I won't be doing a weapon review, but I'll be linking some videos down below in the description that you guys can check out. And when I tell you that this weapon is pretty good, especially in PvE when it comes to DPSing, as many slug shotguns are, I'm telling you, you might want to pick up Unstoppable Shotgun to try to take out some of those unstoppable champions later on when you get to Master and Grandmaster Nightfalls. So that's gonna do it for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I have plenty more Beyond Light content coming. Currently, I'm still playing through the game. I have an impressions video coming up and a review later on. As I do with many of the other things, I don't want to rush anything just to try to be first on YouTube. I want to give you guys really good content. So if you have any suggestions for anything that you want to see from me from Beyond Light, comment down below and let me know. And if you enjoyed this video, be sure to like it, hit that subscribe button, turn on that notification bell, and I'll see you guys on Europa. Peace.